future use of chemical weapons by tyrants everywhere across the globe. Thank you.
Thank you. For ALDE, I give the floor for 2 minutes to Mrs. Shaki.
Hi, Commissioner, colleagues, or High Representative, excuse me. Every time we discuss Syria, we have to mourn more deaths, forcefully disappeared, raped, tortured, and recently, despite the alleged destruction of Syria's chemical weapons, despite international law, hundreds, including children, choked to death because of the use of chemical weapons. And these children cannot possibly be terrorists, as President Assad claims with every citizen that he kills, and it cannot go unanswered. But even just now, and we've heard it as the EU position over and over again, the mantra is there is no military solution to the war in Syria. And I want to question whether this is not also a product of our lack of a decisive role in creating peace and being contributing to peace in that country, because clearly, and I really hate to observe this, military brutality by the cynical coalition of Assad, Putin, and Tehran-steered militants, they are creating facts on the ground. And the facts amount to war crimes. I'm convinced of that. So what we must avoid as the EU by repeating that there is no military solution, we must avoid that this becomes the carte blanche for the status quo and for ever further creeping facts on the ground. In fact, we need an EU strategy to end the war in Syria desperately if we want to be serious about ending the war. 7 years of bloodshed, several vetoes by our member states, disruption in Syria and the Middle East, but also impact here in Europe. People seeking shelter and asylum, feeding also, unfortunately, politics of fear that are seeking to exploit the situation. It impacts us globally and certainly in Europe. So I think for next week, the Syria conference is another opportunity for the EU to develop a strategy, and I welcome accountability and justice being the key priority. It is an essential ingredient for peace, and so hopefully the EU as a whole can build on the Dutch, German and Swedish initiative to centralize accountability. Thank you.
Thank you. For the Greens, for 2 minutes, Mrs. Lochbieler.
Thank you very much, Chair. The Brussels Donors Conference in the coming weeks should be focusing on the following areas, protecting civil